Okay, so let us begin, students. All right, so we'll be studying a new chapter today. We'll be starting with a new chapter, that is modern periodic table. You all already know what it is, but now we are going to study this modern periodic table quite in detail. Okay, this is how your modern periodic table looks. What is this? In this modern periodic table, there are 118 elements, okay, all the elements that are present. Put in a tabular format so that it is very easy to remember what or where the element is, and according to the position of the element, okay, where the element is placed in this periodic table, we can determine its properties. Okay, fine. So you all have seen this already. Let us just look at the introduction part of this chapter. Okay, now students, before there were some scientists who tried to discover various methods of how to arrange the elements that are available. Okay, so students, please let me know. Just a minute. Yes, what happened? Miss, सभी 118 elements पढ़ना है क्या? देखो, सभी elements हमको पढ़ना तो नहीं है, लेकिन कैसा है? If you all memorize all the elements well and good, especially from MCQs. Okay, fine. Because if you all know which element comes after what, okay. Okay, wait, Saurabh, don't worry about it. I'll get to that point. Okay, we are just beginning. Okay, how to remember and what, I'll explain all that. Don't worry. Okay. All right. So the starting part, I hope students, you all know that broadly, all the elements, they are kind of classified into three categories. That is metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Okay, I hope you all are familiar with this thing. Okay, you all know what metals are, you all know what non-metals are. Metalloids are something somewhere in between metals and non-metals. Okay, yeah. So as I was saying that before, there were some scientists who came up with different methods of arranging the elements, okay, that were known at that time. Students, please let me know if you all know about Daubigny's, Triads, and Newland's octaves. You all know about
Yes, miss, we know.
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay, excellent. Now, I think so, since it was covered already, they have not explained much about it in this chapter. Okay, fine. Anyone can recollect what Daubigny's triads were? Anyone would like to answer?
Sum of two.
Miss, three atoms were taken. The sum of the...
Okay, okay. Yeah, you all are getting to the point. Elements. Yes, yes. Group of three elements.
Having similar chemical properties.
Yes, okay.
No,
are arranged in an increasing atomic number order.
Okay, okay, fine. See, students, just a minute, okay? All of you all are almost correct, okay? I'll just quickly show it to you all. First, tell me, you all can see the screen. Just a minute, just a minute. Okay, now can you all see the screen?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
This thing, the Google screen, okay? All right. So, according to me, like all of you all almost gave the correct answers. See, Daubigny's triads or Daubigny's law, the one that you all were trying to say, sum of something, you know, it is Daubigny's law, okay? So, what was Daubigny's triads? That man, whatever elements were available during his time, okay, when he discovered this thing, what he did was, he took three elements and grouped them together. And what was the common thing between these three elements? Their properties. Okay, as one student said, all right. The three elements, the group of three elements, they showed similar physical and chemical properties. That is the reason he grouped them together. One more important thing over here was that if you all just have a look at this statement over here, the Daubigny's law of triads states that the arithmetic mean of properties of the first and the third element in a triad is nearly equal to the properties of the second element. So the point that you all were trying to tell, okay, so the arithmetic mean of the first and third element is equivalent to the that of the second element in the Daubigny's triad. Okay, so what he did, he found out this law. Okay, firstly, he arranged elements in group of three, and these elements had similar physical and chemical properties. Okay, fine. And this next thing, the law that you all said. Students, this is not there in your chapter, okay? So don't worry about it. No one is going to ask you all questions on this in your boards. But still, if you all know this, if you all can recollect, then well and good. Okay, fine. Next, we have Newland's octave. So, anyone remembers what Newland's octave was? or what was that law?
First and the seventh element
were increased in an increase. Atoms were arranged in an order of an increasing atomic weight.
Yeah, atomic weight, atomic mass, correct.
Newland made 8 columns like Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do, the octaves.
Okay.
And according to that, he arranged those atoms.
Okay, good, good, good. Very good, very good. Okay, so students, here, I hope you all can screen now. See the screen. The next thing I have what? Okay, about Newland's octaves. All right, fine. So just let us just read this first paragraph. The Newland's law of octets states that when elements are in arranged in increasing order of atomic weights. Students, I hope you all know there are two factors. There are very two important factors about an element. That is atomic number and atomic mass or atomic weight. Okay, I hope you all know this. Okay, so atomic number, that is represented by Z, and your atomic mass is represented by capital A. Yes or no? Students, you all know about this, right?
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay, fine, good. So, your Newland, what he did was, he arranged, just a minute, okay, students? The marker thing, okay. So, he arranged the elements in increasing order of their atomic mass. But again, students, during his time, not many elements were discovered. Okay, fine. And the major drawback of these two theories was that there was no scope for fitting of new elements. Okay, the new elements that were discovered later, they were not fulfilling this criteria, or they were not, satisfying this theory. So that is the reason these theories were discarded. So even if we don't use them now, we should know about a little bit about history of how, reached modern periodic table. Okay, so let us read this first paragraph. The Newland's law of octets states that when elements are arranged in increasing order of atomic weights, that is atomic mass, every 8th element has similar properties to that of the first. Okay, fine. So every 8th element will have properties similar to that of the first. In other words, the properties of elements are repeated after every 7th interval. So after the 7th element, the properties are repeated again. Okay, fine. So students, this was just a minute. Daubigny's, I'll share the PDF. Hold on. Okay, fine. So this was about Daubigny's triads and Newland's octave. Okay. And here in Newland's octave, the elements were arranged in increasing order of atomic mass. Okay, fine. So this was discovered earlier. Then came Mendeleev. All right. So, if you all can see over here, in 1869, Russian chemist Dmitry Mendeleev, okay, he put forwarded periodic table, etc. Okay, and it's Mendeleev's law. What was Mendeleev's law? See, Mendeleev's periodic law. What you all can do is you all can just mark this and keep, okay? It is anyways in bold, so there's no need to worry, but still you all can mark and keep. The physical and chemical properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic masses. So, the periodic table that Mendeleev discovered. So, what he did was the same thing that what the previous scientists were doing. He arranged the elements in increasing order of their atomic masses. Okay, fine. That is the capital A value. All right, fine. So this was his periodic law. This was his periodic law, all right, which states that the physical and chemical properties of elements are function of their atomic masses. Okay, fine. If I move ahead, just a minute, okay. Okay, so students, I'll get to this part. Okay, fine. All right. Now students, can anyone tell me what is the major difference between Mendeleev's periodic table and the modern periodic table? This is different. Okay, the modern periodic table that we are studying, it is different. It is a new discovery after Mendeleev. So what is the major difference between both of them? Does anyone recollect?
Atomic number.
Yes.
Atomic.
Modern periodic table.
Okay, yeah, please go ahead. Answer in complete statement, like a full sentence, not just one word.
Mendeleev arranged the elements in an increasing order of atomic masses, while Moseley arranged the elements in an increasing order of atomic number.
Number. Okay. So the very big, very good. The very big difference was, students, in Mendeleev's periodic table, the elements were arranged in increasing order of atomic masses, whereas the new modern periodic table that was discovered by Henry Moseley. Okay, it is written over here. In that, he arranged the elements in increasing order of atomic number. So, according to the modern periodic table, students, the law is changed a little bit. Okay, fine. See, this was the law proposed by Mendeleev, and this is the law proposed by Moseley. All can see the physical and chemical properties of the elements are periodic function of their atomic numbers. Okay, fine. So, this is something you'll already know. Very good. Okay. Now, what you will do, students, see. In your textbook, they have omitted out some topics which are not there in your final exam. So, in this chapter, hardly they have just removed two topics. And in that, the first topic is this introduction one. Okay, so you all can just put a cross over here and keep. I'll still discuss it, okay? Anyways, there are not many important points in this topic, but please pay attention to the explanation because it is my job to explain, okay? But you won't be getting any questions from the introduction part of your chapter, of this chapter. Okay, so you all can put a small cross and keep over here. Okay, fine. All right. Now, students, what I want you all to do is, I want you all to mark this second paragraph. You all can see. Just mark this paragraph, okay? Why I'm asking you all to mark this paragraph? Because you all have to read this paragraph. Okay, it is. They have written a little bit about Mendeleev's periodic table. So we can just once read it on your own and you all will understand what is happening. Okay, fine. So see, in Mendeleev's periodic table, elements belonging to the same group, they have basically written some properties about Mendeleev's periodic table. Students, I hope you all are familiar with the term period and groups. Okay, so in the periodic table, the horizontal rows are called periods. Okay, and the vertical columns are called groups. Okay, you all know this, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, fine. All right. So for people who don't know or cannot recollect, horizontal rows are called periods and the vertically, if you go column wise, it is called group. Okay. So in Mendeleev's periodic table, elements belonging to the same group showed similar properties. This was one property about his periodic table. Next, properties of elements in series/period. Okay, now students, Mendeleev called the horizontal rows as series. Okay, the term period was, it came later, all right, but according to Mendeleev, the horizontal rows were called series, according to him, and vertical columns were groups only. Okay, so properties of elements in a series/period show gradual variation from left to right. Okay, so according to him, if the elements are in the same group, they have same properties. And across a period, the properties change from left to right. Okay, fine. Later students, when we'll study modern periodic table quite in detail, y'all might see that some properties resemble to your Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, even though the arrangement is completely different. All right, fine. What is the next line? Mendeleev left some gaps corresponding to certain atomic numbers in the periodic table so as to maintain the periodicity of the properties. Okay, fine. So while he was arranging, he knew that something is missing because then all the elements were not discovered. So for missing elements, he left spaces in his periodic table. Okay, fine. Mendeleev's periodic table was accepted by the scientific community since the newly discovered elements fitted well into the gaps with the properties as predicted by the Mendeleev's periodic law. So the spaces that he left, okay, the spaces that he left, if for example, if a new element was just discovered, so that element fit very well into that empty space. So basically what he predicted was absolutely correct. Okay, students, I think so in the last year textbook, no, they had given about those elements as well. Like in the previous syllabus, little more about Mendeleev they had given, but it is not there in your textbook. So let us not go into that detail. Anyways, our concentration is modern periodic table. Okay, fine. See the last point, inert gases. I hope you all know what inert gases are. Inert gases or noble gases, if you all know your modern periodic table, they are present in the very last column. and these are the stabilized gases. Stabilized means their electronic configuration is complete. Okay, they are either in a duplet state or octet state. Okay, fine. I hope you all understand this. If not, then don't worry. We'll see that ahead. So, inert gases not predicted by Mendeleev and discovered in the later years also could be accommodated in this periodic table. Okay, so in Mendeleev's periodic table, inert gases were not discovered. But even if they are discovered, we can just put that at the end. So basically what they are trying to say is Mendeleev's periodic table had a lot of this thing, positive points in it. Okay, fine. Later, let's just move a little down. Okay, fine. Let's read ahead. After the discovery of atomic structure, the atomic number, which was an original number assigned to element in Mendeleev's periodic table, was recognized. Okay, I hope you all know this. Okay, what atomic number is. Okay, atomic number is the number of protons. Okay, fine. This was outcome of Henry Moseley's experiment, etc., etc. Okay, so basically, when Henry Moseley was working with this, he realized that how important atomic number is. Okay, fine. See, this is the X-ray spectroscopic experiment, etc. He did. Okay, fine. So, see, Moseley showed that frequency of the X-ray emitted by an element is related to the atomic number. Okay, fine. So, if any element is emitting X-ray, so the frequency of that wave depends upon the atomic number. Students, again, all these things are not that important. Okay, fine. So if you are not able to follow, it's okay, fine. No one is going to ask questions on these. Okay, fine. Just the thing is that one important factor, remember, when Moseley was studying an atom, he realized that the atomic number was considered as the fundamental property. He realized that atomic number is an important property, more important than atomic mass. So he found out the new modern periodic table. Okay, so students, this was just the introduction part. Okay, the one thing here you all can mark is that the modern periodic table is also called the long form of periodic tables. It's just an alternative name. Okay, fine. Okay, so students, this was introduction. We have not covered anything important as such till now. All right, these are the things that you all already know. Okay, see. Structure of modern periodic table. Now let us discuss what is the basic, some terminologies that you all should be familiar with. So students, first two terminologies I already explained, that is what is a period and what is a group. Okay, so vertical columns are called groups. They have also written over here. Okay, fine. And your horizontal rows are called periods. Okay, fine. It is written over here. Okay, fine. Students, in our modern periodic table, there are altogether 7 periods. Okay. Fine. And there are altogether 18 groups. So you all have to remember all these things. Okay. Fine. Then what other terminology is there? Let us just look at this paragraph quickly. Look at this topic. Okay. See, the modern periodic table, you all can mark this and keep. Okay, students, if you all want. The modern periodic table has horizontal rows intersecting the vertical columns. This is something you all already know. Mark this. Mark from here till here. Okay. The horizontal rows are called periods, which were called series in Mendeleev's periodic table. And the vertical columns are called groups. Again, something that you'll already know. Still mark it and keep, okay? Because if when y'all are reading, y'all will just have a look at it once. Okay? There are 7 periods and there are 18 groups, okay? The points that I just discussed. Let's see ahead what they have written, okay? This numbering of the periods and groups is recommended by IUPAC. Okay, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. So this is a universal thing. Okay, it's not like here it is something else and some other part of the world it is something else. No, universally, modern periodic table is modern periodic table only, no matter where you all go. Okay, fine. Anything else? Okay. Below, see this point, you can mark this point, students. Below the main table are placed two series containing 14 elements each. Okay, fine. You all can see below the, this is the main table. And below this main table, there are two series. This is called lanthanoid and actinoid series. Okay. Now, students, this lanthanoid and actinoid series are actually present over here. Now, a very big advantage is that this is color coordinated. So, you all can just match the colors and you all will understand. See, this light pink kind of color is lanthanoid and a little bit darker pink or purple, I don't know what color it is actinoid. Okay, so it is actually over here. see the position is over here in the periodic table, but all these elements are almost similar. So if I place all of them over here, obviously my modern periodic table won't be symmetrical. The symmetry will be disturbed. That is the reason, because all of them have almost same properties, they are placed separately and only they are first elements. So you can see the LA and AC, what it is we'll see later. Only the first element is written over here. Okay, so it is like you have to assume that all these elements are present over here, but obviously we cannot draw it there, so we write it separately. Okay, fine. So here all together there are 14 elements. Okay, fine. This is one point. Next, okay, all right. So there are in all 118 boxes to accommodate 118 elements in the modern periodic table. You all can mark this and keep as well. Okay. Now, students, it is expected that you all remember all the 118 elements. Okay, fine. Now, don't worry about it. See, there are certain tricks and this thing in which you all can remember. Okay. It is called mnemonics. All right. Students, tell me if in physics you all are done with this B.B. Roy of Great Britain yet. Have you all heard something like this in physics yet?
Yes.
Yes, miss.
B.B. Roy of Great Britain had a very good wife for the finding the values of resistances and all. Yes or no? So this B.B. Roy thing is there. No, it is called a mnemonic. Okay, so mnemonic is like a shortcut we come up to in order to remember something huge. So similarly, for your modern periodic table, even if you all search on the internet, you all will get lot of mnemonics that how to remember the modern periodic table. Okay, so you all will get group-wise mnemonics. Okay, fine. For example, I knew this one thing. I'll show it to you all. Like, I'll see. This consider the first group. Okay, now we all know that hydrogen is there. So let us ignore hydrogen for time being. So you all can see this is Li, lithium, sodium, potassium, Rb, Cs, Fr. So Lina K RBCs for R. Okay, Lina K RBCs for R. So this is one mnemonic. So in that you can remember Lina K RBCs. Li stands for lithium, Na for sodium, RBCs. Okay, for R ka FR. Okay, so in this way there are many mnemonics available in which you all can memorize the modern periodic table. Okay, fine. If you all want, you all can come up with your own as well. तुम खुद का भी कुछ बना के याद रख सकते हो. एट द एंड द थिंग इज यू ऑल हैव टू रिमेंबर द एलिमेंट्स एस्पेशली फॉर योर एमसीक्यूज एस्पेशली फॉर योर एंट्रेंस एग्जाम. ओके फाइन. सी ऑब्वियसली इन योर बोर्ड्स नो वन इज गोइंग टू आस्क यू दैट ड्रॉ द एंटायर मॉडर्न पीरियोडिक टेबल. दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन. ओके, बट इफ यू आर अवेयर ऑफ मेनी एलिमेंट्स देन इट इज अ गुड थिंग ओनली. एस्पेशली फर्स्ट 30 एलिमेंट्स यू ऑल शुड नो ओनली. लाइक you all should know it without fail. Okay, first 30 means starting from atomic number 1 till 30. Okay, fine. So we'll see that ahead. Don't worry about it. Next, let's concentrate on this last paragraph, students. The overall shape of the modern periodic table is divided into 4 blocks. Okay, now this part is important. So what are the 4 blocks? S, P, D, F. Ye SPDF kahi suna suna lag raha hai na? What is SPDF? Anyone remembers what was SPDF? I have explained this.
Orbitals.
Yes, the orbitals, or you all can say the subshells. Okay, your shell that is there, the orbit that is there, inside that orbit there are suborbitals, there are subshells present. Okay, so this SPDF are the subshells of your orbits. Okay, fine. Like the orbit K, L, M, N. So inside this K, L, M, N also there are small, small orbits which are called subshells, which are labeled as S, P, D, and F. So students, if you all see in your periodic table, we have 4 blocks, okay? On the left-hand side, the 2 groups, okay? The group 1 and group 2, they comprise of S block. Okay, fine. It is written over there. It is written over here. So you all can mark it and keep, okay? See, 2 groups on the left form S block. 6 groups on the right constitute P block, 10 groups in the center form D block, and the 2 series at the bottom form F block. Okay, fine. So your group 1 and 2, this part actually it is not written over here. I think so. There is one more. Okay. See, students, in your textbook, there is one more diagram. Now it is horizontal. So just try to see where my cursor is. So you can see above group 1 and 2, what they have written, S block. Then from group 3 to group 12, it is D block. From 13 to 18, the last 6, it is P block. And these last two series that are there, lanthanoid, actinoid, it is called F block. Now students, SPDF are subshells of the orbits. So from this only you all can understand that your periodic table that is there, wo kaise bhi nahi arrange kiya hai. It has been arranged very systematically according to electronic configuration and everything. Okay, fine. We'll see that as soon as you all understand how to write electronic configuration, you all will find this chapter very easy. Very easy. Like you all have to just read it once. That's it. And obviously you all have to memorize the elements. That is one task. But apart from that, if you all know how to write configuration, this chapter becomes very easy. Okay, so students, till here, I don't think so. We have covered much, just the introduction about modern periodic table and all. See the next topic, periodic table and electronic configuration. So for this topic now, I need to teach you all how to write electronic configuration. Okay, fine. Students, please let me know if you all are understanding what is happening till now.
Yes, miss.
Yes, miss.
Okay, fine. All right.